Starting off tonight with Mountjoy X, which is an Irish dry stout from Stone Angel Brewing in Winnipeg. They describe it as a traditional dark, roasty, and dry stout with notes of coffee and chocolate, very much in the Irish style with no added flavorings. The name seems to be a reference to a traditional brewery from way back in history in Ireland. Interesting. So tonight, I'm taking a bit of a closer look at this thermal imager, this UNI-T UTi690A thermal imager that Banggood sent me for review or project feature or whatever we want to call this kind of a video. You probably already saw the unboxing on the mailbag video up there in the corner, so I won't bore you with that part. Let's just get right to it. In the box, we have the thermal imager itself. We have a 16 gig SD card, we have a USB-C charging lead, and we have a manual in Chinese and in English. 25 pages in each language. I'm not going to bother reading through all of the specs. For a hobby unit like this one is, I'll just go through the very basic stuff. It claims to have a temperature range of minus 20 to plus 400 Celsius. Although the accuracy spec is plus or minus 2 degrees Celsius or plus or minus 2%, whichever is greater, in the range between minus 10 and 400. It can do Celsius or Fahrenheit, and it has a bunch of different palette modes. The display is 320 by 240. However, the sensor itself is 120 by 90. But the first order of business with anything with a screen on it . So this guy is a fairly entry-level thermal imager. The one thing that they're doing to keep the cost down is it's only a thermal camera. It doesn't have a visible light camera in it. So on the front here, we have the thermal sensor. We have a little LED and we have a laser. Yeah, it's got a laser. So that basically allows you to do targeting where it's pointed at. On the back side here, we have four buttons, a power button, an OK button, and an up-down selector. A 1/4-20 thread on the bottom, so you can put it on a tripod. There's a trigger on the front. And up top here, we have the USB-C connection, and we have a spot to plug in the micro SD card, which plugs in exactly as you would expect a micro SD card to plug in. And then there's a little flap on top to keep the gravel out, I guess. The unit claims an IP54 rating and a 2-meter drop survivability. For those not familiar, IP54 translates to this. The first digit, 5, shows that it's dust protected. Ingress of dust is not entirely prevented, but it must not enter in sufficient quantity to interfere with the operation. The second digit of the 54 being 4, protected against splashing the enclosure from any direction, shall not have a harmful effect. And there's all the specs and everything of what that test is. So I have never had a thermal camera before, and this one is the least expensive one I could find on Banggood when I was asking them for it. So is it any good for a hobby shop like yours and mine? Well, maybe, probably. Let's find out. It's kind of difficult to film a camera here, film the screen of it here. I'm just going to take a picture of that and insert it in editing, which you do by squeezing the trigger. And you saw the image flash for a second. I'll do that one more time. You saw the little laser icon up on the top when you squeeze and hold the trigger. And then when I release it, when I just do it quickly, it saves. So aiming at my sign back there, it's showing right in the center of the scrolling LEDs, which is right where that crosshair is, that crosshair there. That is what shows up in the top here. And then on screen, there's two other points. It's showing the coolest spot, which right now is 16.9 or 17, which is the tools that are behind the thing. And then in the middle there, it is showing the hottest spot, which is on that little red crosshairs there, except for it keeps bouncing around because it's always picking the hottest spot, and that's 30.7. Then there is the scale colors on the side for those who use colors to determine things. Okay, so let's just quickly go through the menus here. The OK button takes you into the menu. There's an image view display, and if you click on OK one more time, it will show you the images that are on the SD card. There's a whole bunch of them that I've been playing with. But there is the one that I just took a second ago. And like I said, I will have thrown it up on the screen already in editing. And when you're in the menus, the power button is the back button. Screen display. Okay. So you turn on the center point crosshairs or turn them off. They're on right now. The high and low points, which I was pointing out earlier. You can change the palette. You can change the date and time. Palette is the little legend that goes up the side there. Let's turn it off quickly here. You see it's not there anymore on the side. If I turn it back on there, you can see it there. I suspect that's probably useful for a lot of people. I'm not convinced with my colorblind eyes. It gives me a lot of intelligence, but I'm a small minority of the population, so your mileage may vary. We have a high-low alert, which you can set up to alert you when the temperatures that it's sensing are above or below certain thresholds, with or without a buzzer. That could be useful if you've got it sitting on a tripod and stuff's happening in front of it that you want to keep track of. There's the LED light. There you can see it's on now. Palette. You can adjust the palette of colors available. So there is what Rainbow HC high contrast looks like. That's the one that I have been using because it works best for my eyes. Lava. Rainbow, which is the default that it comes with out of the box. Iron. Okay. White hot. Black hot. And then back to Rainbow High Contrast, which, as I said, is the one that I prefer. And then there is the General Settings menu where you can set the language. Options are English or Chinese. You can set the temperature units. Celsius or Fahrenheit, of course. Emissivity. That is a little bit tricky for me to explain. Basically, different materials, different surfaces of materials emit infrared, i.e. temperature, in different ways. So that allows you to calibrate and compensate for it. You can turn the laser on or off. Right now I've got it turned on just to help with targeting. Set the time and date, screen brightness, and the auto power off. It can auto power off in 5 minutes, up to 30 minutes, or you can disable that. Auto save. And that saves to the SD card every time you click the trigger. You can format the SD card. Check the device info. This particular one has firmware 3.7. And then the SD card capacity. And the model is, as you said off the top, UTi690A. So I guess we should look at a few things. There is my beer glass, which is showing a nice, comfortable 9.7 Celsius at the lowest. I like that. Let's try this in a practical application, something that you might actually use it for in your hobby shop. Those of you who have been around for a while may recognize this is the LM317 kit that a bunch of us did speed races, speed kit builds on a while back. I'll click a link to a playlist of people that were involved in that. That was kind of fun. But it is a linear regulator power supply, takes AC in, bridge diode or bridge rectifier, series analog regulator, and then I've just got an 8-ohm load on there just to give it something to work against and create a bit of heat. So we turn that on. Yeah, the LED came on. And take a look at things here. Starting temperature just at this low voltage of the resistor is about 16.2. You'll notice that it goes into self-calibration. Basically, when whatever it's measuring is outside the range that it's showing, it recalibrates and sets new high and low on that bar on the side there. Here we're getting some heat. Can you see that? So the brigulator looks like it's about 42 and a half or thereabouts. Part of that is because this thing's putting out 14 volts AC out of the transformer. I've got this turned fairly low, so a lot of that is being dumped across there. If we crank it up, crank the voltage up, we should notice that resistor starts getting toasty. Oh yeah, look at that. There we go, and it should recalibrate pretty soon as the temperature gets stupid. Yeah. But the important part, I mean, you know the load's going to get hot. The important part, though, is looking at the circuit. We expect the heat sink on that regulator to get hot, but oh, what's going on over here? That full bridge rectifier, those diodes are getting stinking hot. 130, 140. So that is where this thing could probably come in really handy on a hobbyist's bench. Just doing a quick shot of a circuit board to find where the hot spot is if something's not working properly. If you're drawing excessive current like I was, because I'm drawing far too much current for those little diodes there. So let's just go and take a quick peek at this thing on the website and gather a bit more information about it, and then I'll come back and draw some conclusions. So here it is on Banggood's website. As I record this, it's selling for $173.99 American. When it's not on sale, it's $219.99. And this is the lowest price thermal imager, thermal camera that I have been able to find anywhere. And that's why I asked Banggood to send it to me. I probably could have convinced them to send me something more expensive, but I want to stick to stuff that a normal hobbyist could reasonably afford if it was something that you wanted to get your hands on. Yeah, you can see they've even got a few other more expensive thermal imagers that they sell. And UNI-T has a whole bunch that are much more expensive as well. Here is the full set of specs that are in the manual, so you can read that there if you choose to. Oh yeah, they talk about analyzing software, and there is some software available for it for Windows only, which is why I'm not showing it to you. There it is there. You can download it from a link on the Banggood page if you want to take a look at it. Anyway, as I said, I unfortunately can't show that to you because it's Windows software and I am a fully Linux house here. It's not on the web page, but I found it in the manual. The battery is lithium ion, 18650, 2600 milliamp hour. It says it can run continuously for 9 hours. And as it says here, the full recharge time right from dead is less than 2.5 hours. So when I was researching, I found a fairly lengthy thread on the EEVblog forum about this very temperature imager, thermal imager. It looks like they first spotted it late 2021 on Banggood. And I'll put a link to this if you want to learn more about it. They've got a whole bunch of information on it, including similar models and whatnot from UNI-T. A couple of them did reviews in it as well, but this is all the same information again. So I'll just leave a link for this if you want to look at it. So there's just a quick look at this UNI-T UTi690A thermal imager, handheld thermal camera. I think it's going to come in pretty handy around here. I'm not going to do a teardown today, mostly because what I found from the EEVblog guys, there's 6 screws holding it together. There's 2 under that little piece of plastic there. There's 2 under there, and there's 2 buried behind the screen. So you have to remove this entire adhesive bezel. And I don't want to do that because I want to actually use this thing. That's why I asked Banggood to send it to me in the first place. You may recall from what I mentioned in the mailbag that I am trying to get these sponsors to stock my shop up with every tool I've ever wanted but couldn't afford. So I'm not going to trash this one just to see what's inside it. But anyway, I think that's that just goes over it quickly. And for the uses that I had in mind for it, I think it's going to come in real handy. I'm not going to use it necessarily for raw measurements, although it does do that. I think I'm mostly just going to use it to try and find hot spots or cold spots in things that shouldn't have them, to quickly identify them and quickly notice them changing. Anyway, if you have any questions or comments about this, of course you can put them down below. If you have any experience with this model or much more expensive models, also chime in. It'd be interesting to hear what other people have to say. As I said at the beginning, this is the only one that I've ever dealt with, so it's hard for me to compare it to other things, but it should do what I want. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.